guys, this is Allison Pryor. We're going to do a stormy sky today, gray stormy sky, like this one up here. And we may make it a little even more stormy than that, but that's one I did a couple of days ago for Mandy. Mandy asked me if I could upload a video lesson on stormy sky. So I got a bit of lightning in there, and I didn't make it too complicated because, you know, mostly people looking at my videos are beginners, and there's no need to add too much. I can always do lots of other videos on different subjects, and if you have something you would like me to paint or you need some advice on, you just can email me and talk to me at AllisonPryor@yahoo.com. So what I'm going to do is, first thing I do for this painting is I'm going to tape it off so that we can figure out our horizon line, and so we know where the sky is going to meet the ground or the foreground. So I am going to do this without trying to get in the way. So I'm going to come down about halfway, little. I don't want to go completely halfway because it looked like the painting is cut in half. So we'll go down under halfway. How's that? So now we'll paint that off, tape that off. And what I like to do is, and what you can do, and lots of different ways of doing your paintings, but this is one way. And you probably, Mandy asked me about wet technique that you see on some of the videos, and they say, you know, in oil painting, they have an underpainting or gesso or black or white. And what that is you can do that also with acrylics. As long as you keep your underpainting wet, then you use that for a wet on wet. That's what that means, that the paint underneath, paint that you're putting on first, whether it's black or white or whatever color it is wet. And when you put wet paint on top of it, you will get some really nice colors because the white or the black will mix with your other colors that you're putting on top of it, okay? So, what I'm trying to do is keep my arm out of the way. And so I'm just putting the wet on there, the white on there for you. So just put on a layer of white, okay? And that we have to keep that wet. We want to keep that wet because the canvas is already white, so we don't really need it if we're not using a wet on wet technique. So right now we're trying to use a wet on wet technique so that we can get a nice stormy gray sky. So what I'm going to do now is I want to show you that you can spray it. If it gets starts to dry a little bit, see with oils. Oils take a long time to dry, but acrylics are pretty fast, so you have to be really on top of keeping it wet, okay? And look, I have black and blue on my palette, and because I have a little bit of blue in the sky, even though it's a gray sky, so I'm going to take some black, because now that white is wet, now I can take some black paint, and I can see that when you go over, see how the white's starting to come through, and it gives that really nice different shades of gray and nice dark stormy sky. So that's why I put that white underneath there, to make it nice. And if you go long strokes, you're going to get the different shades of gray. You look, you hardly need to put any more paint on there. You just keep going with the, because that wet is under, that white is underneath there and it's wet, then that means that you can use a bit of black. And so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put some blue in there too. So let's make it look like we have some blue in the sky. So like I said, because we had that white underneath there, and then I put black on top of it, now we get all these really nice different shades of gray. Isn't that wonderful? Yeah. So what now? I'm going to let that, let me see, should I let that, yeah, I'll let that dry. I'll let it dry, okay? And so you work on that part. I'll just do a small bit at a time for you. This will be your step one. So we got a gray sky going on there. And then when I come back, then we'll put in some clouds. Okay, so just try that first. Put your wet paint, wet white, wet paint on.
your canvas, and then while it's still wet, if it starts to dry on you, just spray it with some mist, water, and then take some black paint and paint over the white, and you'll see all these different colors of gray coming through. The big flat brush, that's the brush that we used. I forgot to mention it, but that's a Bristol brush that we used, and about a half an inch for to put the sky and the underpainting on. So I'm going to use the same one, and I'm going to just put a bit on the edge of my, see, just on the corner of my brush. And I'm going to pick a spot on here. I'm going to look for lines. See, I'm going to see maybe, oh look, there looks like a little one right there. See that? That's where I'm going to put my little cloud. And I'm just going to tap it on. Tap, 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 tap. Okay, now if your paint is dry, I let it dry. And if it's dry, that your cloud may come out a little bit too bright because it is a stormy sky. So what we can do is we can add a bit of black to our white and make a gray cloud. Okay, so make some gray clouds, and then that will tone them down, and then we can highlight them after. So this cloud is a bit bright, but that's okay. So we'll just go over that a little bit. Just start at the top and start moving some gray around that. We'll leave a little bit of white there if you like. So just move your brush around. Tap, 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 tap. So just pick some places that you want to put some clouds. Make them look stormy. You have to have them a bit dark. That's all. That's a secret. Stormy clouds and skies. Just that is dark with grays and blacks and some blues. Okay, so just put some gray on your, right? Just a bit of black and a bit of white mixed together, and tap, tap, tap it together so that it looks like a grayish color. And then we'll pick another spot, maybe on that line there. Look for lines. Look for places that can guide you along for clouds. So that's a line right there. So we'll just throw on another cloud here. Just tap it. It'll make it a little easier for you to tap the clouds on. Okay, because there's lots of ways to do things, but I'm going to find an easiest way I can for you today. So tap on your clouds, and you just move it around. Tap, 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 tap until you're happy. Okay, and you can blend in the bottom part with the rest of your sky. You can just move your brush around. All right, just move your brush around just so that we can get some nice clouds in our sky. And we can add a little bit more whites and grays together to get our clouds. And we'll add probably another cloud here. I got a hole in my canvas, so I'm going to cover that up with a cloud. Okay, there we go. And then move around your brush on the bottom here. That's all. Good. So tap, 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 tap. And then move your brush around on the bottom so that it all blends together, okay? Make it more realistic looking. So just take your time. Have some fun with it. Find a place that you like to have your cloud. If you want to have one, I see a line over here. See those lines? Use them as a guide. So just tap, 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 tap. That's a pretty dark cloud there. That's fine. But we can certainly brighten it up. Just take your brush, add a little more white to it. Tap it off on your palette. And then start tapping on the top of that cloud that you just made. On the top, okay? And that'll give you some darks and lights. So I want to have dark, stormy sky. We don't want to have it too white. So we'll just blend it out. Blend it out. It's okay to go and put more color into your sky. It's okay. All right, so then we'll put some more clouds in. So see all this brightness that I put in there? I'm going to use them for clouds. So I'm just tapping into my black and white so I can get some different color grays. And I'm going to tap on some more clouds. There we go. So just tap, 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 tap. Even if you can barely see them, it's okay, because that gives it a kind of a fluffy looking sky anyway. So, you know, because you look up in the sky and sometimes you can't even see clouds. So just tap all around. Tap, 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 tap. Okay. And then just blend it out into the sky. And then we'll just put more clouds over there to brighten it up. And all you need is a bit more white. Okay, there we go. That's a nice one. So just tap around your whole sky just to see what comes up, you know, experiment and have some fun with it. Don't worry about getting a perfect cloud or, you know, you can, this is great for practice, have a bit of fun with. I'm going to put a cloud here, so I need more white. See, I mean, I have times I'm struggling too, you know. Struggle, struggle, struggle. Sometimes you look at some videos and they look like, gosh, they make it look so easy. How come you can do it so easy? It's not as simple as you think. I mean, and it is. It is and it isn't. It's just that you just have to keep practicing and have some fun with it and struggle along with each cloud or tree or whatever you're doing. And if it gets bad enough that you really don't like it, just take it all out and go back to your original color and start over. So I'm just putting in some extra little highlights here and there. So you do whatever you want with it. I'm just giving you some, you know, some techniques that are pretty simple, and just let you know that you can do whatever you want, okay? You can put more clouds in than I have, or you can put less clouds in than I have, as long as you got some nice clouds going on there. So as long as you tap, you're going to get all kinds of nice clouds. It'll just happen for you on your big old brush. They'll just happen. They'll just pop right out there. You won't even realize. You'll be like, how'd that happen? Look at that cloud. Oh my, where'd that come from? So, you know, you just play around. So we'll put on some more. We'll play around a little bit, and maybe there's one over here. Just tap it around. Okay, maybe there's one under here. I'm going to take whatever's left over on my brush. Now, I'm not even going to go back and get more paint. I'm just going to take whatever's left over on my brush, and I'm just going to tap into my sky here and there and everywhere. Okay, so just tap around, make some small ones, just leftover paint on your brush. Just tap around, and make some. There we go. See, just tap, 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 tap. That's all you have to do is tap around. Tap around. Hopefully my arm's not in the way. So, you know, just have some fun with it. And you can even scrunch in a few little soft ones over here. Look, see that? Just touch and push. Only leftover paint, though. Don't get too much paint. Touch, touch. Push, 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 push. Round, round, round circles. Make a few little fluffier ones there if you like. Yeah, just make all kinds of stuff, you know. And if it gets really bad, just go back to your, go start over again, or just go back and go with grays and just have some fun with it. Don't let it, you know, make you upset or think that you can't do it. You know, so I'm going to put some more white on top of the ones I just made, just to give it a realistic cloud look. So if you put on some clouds that are too gray, just put a bit of white on the corner of your brush and just go at the very top of that cloud, the very, very top. Tap it on. Tap, 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 tap. Tap, 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 tap. Right? Just tap it around. Whatever's left over in your brush, then you can move it around. You can move your brush around as long as you don't get big white blobs. So your big white blobs, as we'll say, will go on the very top. See? The very top of your cloud. And then as the paint is coming off your brush, then you can start moving around underneath what you just did. All right. So that's that much. And if you want to, we can put a little bit of lightning in there. I'm just going to put it in now before I run out of time. So all you have to do is get a toothpick. Toothpick. That easy. For your lightning. Well, let's grab a spot. Let's just pretend they're there. So take your toothpick and run it around your clouds until you get some white. Oh, you know what happened? My white underneath is dry. So that has to be done when your white underneath is wet. So we'll take our liner brush. So when the paint underneath is still wet, you can use your toothpick. If you're using oil paintings, it'll always be wet. So that's the difference between oil and acrylics. So let's just take a little liner brush, long liner brush, put a little tiny bit of paint on the end, and we'll find a spot for lightning, and we'll just drag down some lightning. Okay. You just take your brush and go boop, boop, just like you're drawing a line. And so you just go back and get more paint if you can't get it to work. There we go. And come down, 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 down. So I don't see a big lot of lightning around here in Newfoundland. Not like in some parts of Canada. So we're just going to make some lightning streaks. So if you need more paint, just go back and get it, okay? I'm using my little finger to steady my hand a little bit. And you just bring it all out. Take one line off the other line. And make these little streaks of lightning. Here we go. Just little streaks of lightning. Wiggle, 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 wiggle. Wiggle, 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 wiggle. Okay, so you keep making those streaks of lightning. And make them whatever way you want to do them. You can have long ones or short ones. Have them all over the place. And that's it. That's pretty simple. But you can use a toothpick if your paint underneath is wet. And that way it'll bring out the white paint underneath. All right. But because of our acrylics are a little, they dry faster. So, like I said, if that was oil paint, you would have been able to do that. But just keep putting your streaks in whatever way you want your lightning. Just take one line off the other line and wiggle it around. Something like you do your branches on your trees. Okay? Now, there's one little thing too. Wherever lightning is coming out of, you can put a bit of white around it as the cloud is bright now. The cloud brightened up because lightning came out of it. So that cloud there has to have a bit of light to it. Okay, and maybe it's a bit light on this one here because it's going past that one, probably behind it. So because it's going behind that cloud, we brighten that up and it's coming out from underneath it. So anywhere that the lightning is passing through, we like to probably lighten it up a bit. Okay, so we'll just wiggle in a little bit of light. Wiggle in a little bit of light. So I'm just going to brighten up the sky down here a little bit. And then just going to add a little bit of this, and I'm just going to make a few circles to go over my clouds a little bit more, just to give them a little more of a fluffier look. All right, see, I'm just going over them a little bit with your same brush, big flat brush, just by going over them a little bit more, that makes them look a little fluffier, and then you can also add a little bit of white on top of those. Okay, so don't be afraid. I came back again and decided, you know, to show you that you can continue, just tap on the top, that you can play with your sky as long as you want, you know. Just because I say I'm finished, don't mean that you got to finish. You can go ahead and add more clouds and take out clouds if you don't like them, you know. Just go back and forth and until you get what you like. I could do this, like I said, for a long time, but I'm just going to try and get as much done as I can for you. Every now and then I make these little round circles. I just push in and make little round circles. And then these up here I think needs a little bit of oomph to them, so we'll just go a little few little circles up here. Just push whatever's left on your brush there, just push it in to the sky. There we go. That'll give you nice stormy clouds. Probably another one here. I'm just using the corner of my brush, okay? Corner of my brush. Look, there's hardly any paint on it. And I'm just going around circles, that's all. Just, and you can try your tapping motion or your circles or whatever way you feel that you can get those on there, you know? Just put them on. I'm just going to go over some of these clouds just to make them a little more softer. Okay, I like to have one down here. Just pushing and turning, pushing and turning. Something like I had another video out too that did basically this kind of a push and turn. And I'm just going to lighten it up down here a little bit, scrubbing it in. Scrub, 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 scrub. And then I'm going to add a little bit of white to this top here, just close to where the lightning is too, because you know, if you look at the sky when it's a really dark, stormy sky, you'll see some light coming through the clouds because there's lightning and lots of good stuff going on in there. So I'll just put on some more clouds. And we'll fluff these up a little bit here too. These are pretty good. I want to keep nice and stormy. I don't want to end up with a sky that don't look stormy. So as long as you got the darks in there, and as long as you got, you know, dark blacks and grays, you know, you'll have a nice stormy sky. So I'm just shoving in some extra cloud, just brightening it up a little bit here and there. Even though it's supposed to be a stormy sky, it makes it look even more stormy when you got some blacks and grays. Okay, so I'm going to leave that, and then we're going to start our next section. So I'll just throw in a little bit of light color down here, so I wanted to make it a little bit lighter down here. Okay, so that's that. I'll leave that alone. I could do that, like, lots of things I like to do with it, but I'm going to leave it for you. So you can, like I'm trying to show you, you can have any kind of sky you want, as long as you got the black and the grays and a little bit of blue. I did lose a little bit of my blue there, but like I said, I'm not going to spend too much time in the sky. You can spend as much time on it as you want to. So here we go now. So we're going to do our grass, our bottom part, and the easiest way out of this is to paint green paint on first. Just get an underpainting of green paint on first, just so we can get something started. Okay, so there we go. Green paint, come up to your line, to your horizon line. Turn your brush this way. That's the horizontal way, okay? Horizontal, I always say this horizontal and this is vertical, to make it a little easier for you to understand what I'm saying to you. So just put on your green underpainting. And we can also work on the bottom as wet on wet. So we'll say the green here is wet paint. And we'll put all that on and make it nice and wet. If it goes dry on you, then you know you can add, you can splash it with some water or spray it with some water. Okay? So just get your green on there. Get your green on. We'll lighten it up with some yellow in a minute. Okay. So I'm just getting some green on my palette. I have a pretty messy palette here because I'm working from the same palette with all my videos, and I'm after picking up a little bit of black there. I didn't mean to, but that's the problem when you keep using the same palette and you add all these different colors. So I would suggest that you separate your dark colors on another palette from your lighter colors. So what I should be doing, but I'm the teacher. So, but for your advice, get two palettes, one with your dark colors and another palette with your light colors. Okay? So, get all that green on the bottom here so we can get the grass started. And your strokes can be back and forth. Doesn't matter about your strokes at this point. You can just go back and forth to get that on there. Alrighty. So let's get all that on there. And when I get that done and get it highlighted, then we'll start something else. So this is now your bottom part for your grass, okay? There we go. Let's get that up there. So now what I'm going to do now is I am going to put on some yellow over that because we have our underpainting of green on there. So now I'm going to just put yellow right on top of it. Look at that. Just right on top of it. And like the sky, you'll see different shades because you put your dark green underneath. Now you put your yellow on top, you're going to get different shades of yellow and green. See? Now don't worry about too much up here. We're going to put some hills up here. So we'll just take this and we will just put our yellows right on top. There we go. Okay, so keep putting your yellows on. Alrighty then. Like I said, I'm after mixing in some dark colors by accident, but don't you worry about that. You separate your colors and just put yellow on there. And I'll put some more yellow on my palette. Oopie-doo. Oopie-doo. Squeezed it out. That's another palette I have, and that's just as much of a mess. So you just get your separate palette full of yellow and just go back and forth with yellow, black and forth. Yes, look at that. And we'll keep brightening it up and keep adding yellow. Lots of paint on your brush. Lots of paint. Lots and lots and lots of paint. Lots and lots of paint. Now, make sure you can see all of that. There we go. So lots and lots of paint. So you already have your green on there. Now you're putting some yellow on top of it. So leave some streaks of yellow. Yep, there we go. Some more yellow on. And we might even add some more yellow after it dries. We'll see now how it goes, okay? So just keep putting your yellow on. And you can turn your brush horizontal or vertical, whatever works for you. Oh, there we go. You can come down, you have them as big as you want or as small as you want. Just go across with your brush. There we go. And now you can fill them in. Just fill them in with your blue first. Okay. So you're almost getting, like where I didn't mix the white and blue totally together, you're almost getting some shadows already being made there for you, see? So you just fill that in with your blue and your white color. And then we'll be adding a little bit of green on top of that too. I'm sitting on the back of the camera trying to keep my hand out of the way, so I'm trying to reach over here. So here we go with our hills. There we go. So we'll just make this little hill in blue first. And then we will put some green on top of that. So I'm going to put some green on my brush, same brush, put some green, and then I'm just going to scrub that green in and just put some green over there. There we go. I hope to keep a little bit of blue there. There'll be some green in your hills. Good. So just keep going across. Now, if you're a right-handed, you might want to start on the other side. So I'm left-handed, and I'm trying to keep my hand out of the way, so you'll see me making these, my hand everywhere here. So we'll just put the green in there, and we will still have some blues. So we can put some blue back in. If we put too much green on, you can put some blue back in, some shadows back here. Some shadows in there. And what we'll do is we'll clean off our brush and we'll rub that in so we can have some nice little shadows in the background. There we go. Some little shadows. Pull down front here. And we'll just touch that up here. All right. So we'll just have those little hills in the background. We'll put a little bit of blue back here for shadows. So the shadows we'll put on the back of the hills on the left side of the hills. And that will give you more of like shapes. So you'll have shaped up hills. There we go. So that's some nice little hills there for you. And if you want more on your hills, just add a little bit more green. This is the way you do your paintings. You go back and forth with your different colors until you get what you're looking for. Until you're happy. And that's the big thing. I always say that. As long as you are happy. Don't you worry about anything else. If you look at your painting and say, oh, I like that. Well, then that's wonderful. And you keep it that way.
So I'm going to clean my brush off, and I'm going to go back to the big brush that we used to put on the grass right here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a few more yellow highlights to this area so we can lighten it up. So just put on some yellow over the green that you already did. We let some of that green come through. Now your paint is pretty dry, so your underpainting is pretty dry, so that's a good thing, because now we want to put on and make it nice and yellow. But we also want to try and keep some of that underpainting, so you can miss some of those greens. Just go right across some yellow. Go up under your hills. We'll put a few little bushes there, so don't worry too much. And go back in with some yellow. And we will put that on top of there. And underneath here, we'll scrape that on. Back and forth. We can still see the greens, but yet you're getting some nice, really nice highlights with your yellows. See? So you keep going with the yellows. If you need more yellow, you squirt it out. Squirt it out of your bottle. I'm just using some bottled paint. I like the texture of it because it's nice and it flows nicely. It's easy to work with. It's the bottle paint. Okay, so let's get some of this yellow on here. Let's go back and forth. Okay, see how that's brightening up really nice, but yet it's not taking away all the green. See? I didn't add any water or anything to it. If you end up doing it and you lose all your green, just put back some green. That's all. Just go back with your green that you put on and put some more of your green back in. But I want this bottom to be nice and bright. Okay, so we'll keep going. Make sure you can see it. Here we go. To make adjustments sometimes, because I can't see these videos until they're finished, and they're a little tedious to make, so I try to get it all done in one take, and sometimes that don't happen. But keep putting your yellows on. If you find that your canvas is too dry, just spray it with water, just spray bottle, and it'll help it flow a little better. Okay, so we get all that on there. Keep putting on your yellow. Like I say, if you feel like you're getting too much yellow, don't go back and get a little bit of green with your yellow. Just watch. I just put a little bit of green in there that time. Look at that. So now you can even flows a bit more. But if you want a lot of yellow, then you're going to have to just go with yellow. So we'll just scratch that in, scrape it in, and get that on there. So it looks like a nice little field of yellows and greens. There we go. That makes it nice. We can always spray a little bit more water. And just spread it out. There we go. Now, that's good. That's another coat of paint with some yellows on top. And now what we're going to do is add some foliage. So we're going to go with a smaller flat brush right now. It's a smaller Bristol flat brush, probably a number 5. But you can see the size of it. It's not very big. So we're going to tap into some green, some black. Okay, some green and some black. Green, black, and tap it off on your canvas till you get, so you can get some, see how the green and the black mix together. So what you see here is what's going to come out on your canvas. There we go, that's nice.
So we're going to pick a spot, and we'll pick a spot here, and we'll just tap. Tap, 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 tap. Tap, 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 tap on some foliage. There we go. Good. You can have it high or low or whatever way you want it. There we go. And just come out narrow on the end here. We'll just make it a little skinnier because it's getting closer to you. So add some more green, a little bit of black, and we'll do some more foliage, let's say, probably right here. You can pick wherever you want it. And we're going to put it on a little bit of a diagonal there. And just tap, 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 tap. We'll put some more yellow in that underneath it so it looks like it's into the grass. Good. And now we'll do probably another one over here. And that's just a tapping motion. Tap, tap, tap. I make this one a little darker. If it came out too light. Good. Okay. And then we are going to go back to the big brush. I'm going to show you my painting again. Hopefully I don't fool up this camera. I'm just going to lift it up. Now I know this one here is a little bit different, but we're getting close. That's the one I just painted earlier, a few days ago. And so we're trying to do one similar to it. So I'm going to put this down now before I drop it. Okay, now on the bottom, as we've seen, we're going to make the bigger foliage. So now all that is, the same thing, is tap into your black and tap into your green so that you get green, and tap it off so you can see if you need more black. So you just tap, 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 tap. Okay, so it looks like we might need more green. We'll be highlighting this after. So what you can do is start off in this corner here and just tap big foliage. Okay, see that? You see that, right? Good. And then you go across your canvas. You can turn your brush either vertical or horizontal. When you want to get the high parts, you can turn it horizontal and then vertical, horizontal and vertical, or whatever way works for you, okay? So we'll just tap into some more green and black when you run out of paint, and add more darks. I like it to be dark because then I can lighten it up. Okay, so we're going to add this right over. And there we go. Good. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to take a liner brush. And we're going to drag that through some black paint. Drag it through some black paint and some green paint, okay? And then you're going to take the liner brush and just pull up some of these nice little, like I say, lightening, and the branches usually have the same curves, and so you can just wiggle, 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 put in as many as you want, just go with the flow, put in some of your little twigs, go get some more paint if you need it, maybe there's a couple coming out of here, maybe there's some coming over here. There we go. A couple of little ones in the background. Little tiny ones. And you just bring out a few wherever you want them. Remember, this is your painting, so wherever you want, you go ahead and do it. Just trying to keep my arm out of the way. Okay, so we'll bring in a few more. Maybe a bigger one down here. Okay, there we go. Good. There we go. A few little ones sticking up here and here. And lighter you touch, the lighter they will be. They'll be smaller. The heavier you touch, the thicker they'll be. And if you want to add a bit of water to your, if you put water on there, that'll make them flow better. Oh, too much. Okay, so let's see how easy it is to fix it. Alrighty, so here we go. Up, 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 up. A little bit of water makes it flow much better. See, I can put lots of them on there now. Just like I'm using a pencil or, you know. This landscape now with the tree. So you're going to get a small flat brush like this. It's a filbert brush, actually. You see it's rounded on the top there. It's not Bristol, it's synthetic or sable. So as long as it's, stiff. And I'm going to put some brown paint, just brown paint, on my brush. And I'm going to pick a spot. Okay, we don't want to lose you. So I'm going to pick a spot. Let's see, we'll start here at the edge of this little foliage. And we'll decide where we're going to go. So let's say we'll come up to about here. And just take your brush and touch. And it will be the horizontal. And you pull, 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 pull. Now you ran out of paint, that's okay. So just go back and get some more. And we'll do it again. So we'll touch and pull, 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 pull down to here. And then we'll just bring out some, because we'll put some foliage around there. And we'll do a nice little tree. So your brush will do it for you. The brush will make the shape for you, okay? And then what we'll do is we'll take our liner brush and we'll drag it through some black and some brown, or just black, and we'll make some nice little branches coming off. So the same motion as before is with your twigs. If you have to put in a bit of water just to get it to loosen up, run it through your black, run through your black or your brown, okay, just run it through. And then take some, decide where you want your foliage, I'm sorry, your, there we go, nice little branches, 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 there we go. So gonna come over here. So put on as many branches as you want, because we are going to be putting leaves on that tree. And if you like a tree without leaves, you don't have to have them, okay? If you like the way these little branches came out and you want to keep them, then all you got to do is keep them. You don't have to have anything. You change it whatever way you want. You can have more of something or less of something. Okay, so just put you're gonna put these on to help guide you so you can put your leaves on. So there we go. Maybe another little one up here. Here, here, here. Wiggle them around. Wiggle, 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 wiggle. There we go. Wiggle. Alrighty. So we get a few of those on and wherever you want them. And then you got them on there. So I think that's plenty for now. So I'm going to take this brush here. Remember that brush I showed you before for flowers? I'm going to use that for our tree. So that's our half inch, just a regular house painting brush. Okay, but I really like it because of the bristles. So I'm going to tap into some green and some black like we do with our foliage. And then we are going to put on our leaves. Now this is the last painting, so I hope to get it all done in this time span that I have, because my camera only lets me paint for so long, you see. Now, so that's the camera that I use, and it gives me really good video. So I'm just going to take this brush and touch, 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 touch. And I'm going to use those. See? I'm going to use those branches to help guide me where I want my tree. So I got the outer edges done, and now I'm going to paint the inner edges. I'm going to fill in on the inside like this. I'm just tapping at it. Tap, 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 tap. I do a lot of tapping. Alrighty then. So you just tap on your tree. Okay. And that's that simple. So now what we're going to do is we're going to highlight, we're going to do some finishing touches, because the painting is pretty well done for me, but you can certainly do whatever you want with it. You can add more trees, you can put a little dog in the field or a cow, or you can add flowers down at the bottom. You can do whatever you want. But this is just the basics that I wanted to show you, some techniques, so you can get started and do whatever you want. So I'm just highlighting the tree a little bit, okay, with some green. Okay, some green on top of that. I'm just touching it lightly. I'm going to take a little bit of yellow. I'm just going to throw that in. I don't know, probably. Let's see, what about if the sun was shining down from the right? So we'll say the sun is on this side of the tree. How's that? So if the sun is on that side of the tree, we'll add some brightness on that side. Okay. And then, like I say, if the sun is shining on that side of the tree, then we'll put the lightness over here. And if it's over there, move it around a little bit too, not too much, just enough to brighten up one side. And if the sun is shining on the tree, it may be coming over here on some of these bushes. So we'll put a little highlight on those, just a little taps, not much, because you know you don't want to overdo it. So we'll just tap a little bit of highlight on those, just a little bit of yellow, not much. Now if you want to add some different colors, you'll get some flowers, but I'm not going to go into that right now. So, and you can also add a little bit of, I'm going to take another brush now. I'm going to take a smaller, let's see, I'm going to take a smaller, yeah, smaller bristle brush, okay, the smaller bristle brush, and I'm going to take some yellow, okay, we're just doing our final touch-ups now, just to finish up the painting, okay. So what I'm going to do is take this foliage here, and I'm going to bring it in with the grass. Okay, get my brush better than that so I can get a better color for you. But that's supposed to be yellow, so when you put your yellows on, make sure your brush is nice and clean. Okay, there we go. So we just put that on there underneath that foliage to make it look like it's going, it's in with the rest of the grass. Okay, you can even lift up a couple little bits of grass around it if you want to. So just blend that in there. So I'm going to put some more yellow on here on this one. Okay, so just put it on there underneath there to clean. We're cleaning up the edges now, that's what we're doing. We're cleaning up the edges and doing some finishing touches. You can lift up if you like. Okay, and just smooth that out over here. And we'll do another one under this foliage here. Because like I say, you want to look realistic, right? Okay, good. Lift up. Lift up, lift. Okay, what else can we do? We need to put something around here, around this tree. So you want to make it look like it's in the grass. There we go. So we could take our small flat brush and we can dip into some black and dip into some green. A little bit of black, a little bit of green, just to darken up your green. And we're going to put a little bit of foliage over here. Just tiny, tiny, tiny bit, because it's way, way back there, way back. A little bit over here, wherever you want it, I'll leave it up to you. There we go. And a little bit over here. And put a little bit here. And you can do whatever you want with your painting. Okay, so I'm just putting a little bit here just to make it look like. And then, of course, now you want to clean up the edges again. So you put some yellow or green or whatever colors you want. There's a lot more that we can do with this, but I'm just going to show you these little things that you can do. Okay, so I think that's the end of this painting. So you go ahead and practice, and when you get it done, if you want to send me a copy of your painting, I'd love to see it. Don't forget, you can add flowers, tree, another tree, a cabin, whatever you want to do with it. You know, more lightning. So I will leave that with you. And I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope it helps you. And I love to see your painting when it's finished. So signing off, that's lesson 5, the end lesson. And I'm signing off. This is Allison Pryor saying, happy painting.